Let's switch over. So here's one of my putty knives, and I want to see how this putty knife works on this. So again, this putty knife would be really handy because it's got the reach. Say you were cutting into a rabbit. You had to clean inside a rabbit like this. So you could clean very, very accurately with a scraper like this, just like I'm doing. So you, most of the time a rabbit is cut with a, especially a large rabbit, is cut with the table saw, and so slight kerf marks are left there that you may want to float out if you need it to look real good. So this is a really handy tool to do that with, and the steel is soft enough that you can just sharpen it and resharpen it many, many times. And they're just a few bucks, putty knives are. You probably got them laying around your shop already. But let me cut into this white oak without any obstruction, just so we can kind of get an idea of how it's gonna cut. Oh yeah, look at that. So in a pinch, you already own this. You don't need to buy something fancy. You already own putty knives. So here you've got a scraper you can use already. Plus a hand scraper, they get so darn hot. You gotta wear a glove and it also jacks up your thumbs trying to hold it in that position. So you have this nice handle. So that looks good. Let's try this bigger one. So here's a bigger putty knife. Let's see how this one's gonna work. A little finer cut, but cutting nonetheless. White oak, you know, it's not the easiest wood to work. It's not the hardest. Here's the putty knife that I hooked both faces. So this one I ground 90 degrees. It didn't have the bevel on it. Let's see how this cuts. Not too good on that side. Better on this side. See, you won't always get it perfect every time. So you may have to, that's why I don't want to put a big investment in putting these things on stones and trying to create my facet, because I may not hook it properly. So I don't want to waste a bunch of time. That's why I just go with the files. If it's not good, bam, I'll just go back to the vise and the file and redo it. And I'm not even gonna think twice about it. See, one side I got good, this side doesn't seem to want to cut. Oh, it's cutting. Here's that profile. I can feel where I put the hook on it here. Oh my goodness, that's medieval there. Look at that. I love the smell of white oak. That's very aggressive. So, you know, you could use this for shaping any number of odd surfaces, both convex or concave. That's really aggressive. So here's one of our little Japanese saws where the blade had been ground off. I think I did this side. Yeah, that's the hook. Very fine pass, very fine, very nice. Look at that, kind of floating over where I had done it with that profile scraper. Nice thing about these is you can kind of keep moving and always finding something fresh there to, and also dissipate the heat. And again, you already own this, you know, so you're making something that you bought and used work for you again without spending any more money. So that steel is good. Save that steel and reuse it. Oh, I think I'm using the wrong side. There it is. Oh yeah. Now for the big Japanese saw blade, I did both sides. I did both sides and both edges, and I did the end. So let's cut a little bit with this and see how this works. Looking good. But like I said, these just take a toll on my thumbs. I jack my thumbs up, you know, holding them in that position. Even with gloves on, I just don't like it. I just don't like to hand scrape unless I absolutely have to. That's why I prefer to use the putty knife technique or my STANLEY number 80. So let me float this out a little bit more here with this. Here's a piece of pretty figured curly maple. So this cuts across the figure without any real risk of pulling a hunk out. Pretty aggressive cut. So here's our putty knife. That's still cutting. Ah, that's hot. Put that mahogany in. So see, I haven't even sharpened yet. So we're still on the same hooks that I created out in the demo. But in just no time, you could go back in and freshen your hooks up using this file and burnisher technique. So you don't have to get your stones out or anything to do it. Now this guy's still cutting. Got clogged up a little bit there. Putty knife. This has got that ribbon stripe in it. That's why this one's gouging that up right there. Doesn't want to cut. Mahogany doesn't really scrape that well. It's not quite hard enough to really want to scrape real well. But I can float it right back out again with this scraper plane. Really get it cranked out now. This is what you need, STANLEY number 80. All the rest of these, take them or leave them. Use a putty knife if you have to, but you gotta have this.